I want a girlfriend.
Huh?
I'm already a sophomore in college, but I'm still single and haven't had a girlfriend for my whole life.
Uh-huh.
I want a girlfriend or two or three already.
That's literally cheating.
Four is fine, too.
You've somehow made it worse.
But at this point, I won't be able to have a girlfriend for my whole life. I'm gonna graduate college without ever having a girlfriend.
Yeah, I think that it's better for the whole world if you just don't make a girlfriend.
Well, I want you to teach me how I could find a girlfriend, actually.
Why are you going to ask me? You know that I've never had a girlfriend either, right?
But you're so popular. You're way more popular than me.
You think so?
See? My name is Isa Ikagaki. I'm just your run-of-the-mill sophomore in college.
I don't know what's so good about being liked by people that I don't even like, though.
The person that's saying things that are clearly only able to be said by popular people is my best friend, Akira Sayagusa. As you can see, he's a very good-looking man.
If the person that you're really interested in won't look your way, do you realize that no matter how much other people are interested, you're just left empty? Don't you get it?
Sounds like you've got experience in that field.
Yeah, it's kinda happening now.
Seriously? I didn't know about that. I'm your best friend and I didn't know?
It's not like I talk to you about everything just because we're best friends. There's like 108 things that I'm keeping a secret from you.
That's actually a lot.
Well, one of those things is that when I shower, I tend to start off by washing between my toes first.
I don't care about that.
Really? My younger sister is actually kind of like me too, though.
Please, tell me more about your younger sister and how she bathes.
You are being way too obvious in your ulterior motives.
The main reason Akira and I started getting along was when we were still freshmen and we were in the same lecture.
Hey, can I sit next to you?
Yeah, go for it. We were in the same major, so we needed the same classes, and we wanted similar certifications, so we pretty much had identical class schedules. Akira was also pretty friendly towards me and kept coming up to me to talk to me, so we just started getting along more. Akira, I really think that you're my best friend.
Really? It's actually kind of, embarrassing when you tell me that kind of thing straight to my face.
What about you?
I think that you're my best friend too.
Oh. And that's how we started getting along well, and we're now best friends. Hey, how do you think I can find a girlfriend?
I don't know.
You know, you really aren't interested in this topic at all, are you? You're just so cold and distant when it comes to this.
You think so?
Ah, I've got it. You must be worried that if I find a girlfriend or something, I'm gonna be spending less time with you, and you don't want that to happen. Or something along those lines, huh? You needy attention seeker.
You really think highly of yourself, huh?
Then, one day... Huh? There's a crowd of girls over there. Is that Akira at the center of them all?
No, please, calm down.
He really is popular, isn't he? I'm so jealous of him. I think that if he wasn't my best friend, I would probably complain about him online, and then he'd take legal action against me to take it down, and we wouldn't be friends. Do not ever bully online. Stop online bullying.
Please, I'm begging you. Tell me what kind of woman Ikigami-gun likes.
What are his hobbies? Where does he normally go when he has free time?
Huh? Wait, did I hear that wrong? I swear that I just heard my name come out of that beautiful girl's mouth.
Does he have a girlfriend?
Where do you think he starts off washing in the shower first?
Is it just me, or are they asking a bunch of questions? They're literally overwhelming him with a bunch of questions about me? What the heck is going on?
You guys are always so annoying about him. I am not going to answer anything about him no matter how many times you corner me and ask me.
How many times? Wait, so this has happened multiple times to the point where he gets annoyed? What the heck is going on right now? Wait, was I super popular and I just didn't know about it this whole time? I see. That's how things really were behind the scenes. Huh. I didn't realize that I'd become so good-looking when I didn't even notice. I had grown into a real man.
Huh? What's that guy doing? Gross.
He's clearly some kind of narcissist. Let's just avoid him as much as possible.
Yeah, that's not what's going on. But they were absolutely bombarding Akira with questions about me. That has to mean that they're curious and want to know about me, right? If they want to know about me, then they have to at least have some kind of positive feeling about me, right? Why would they?
Huh? I swear Ikagaki-kun was right over there!
Crap! I can't have them find out that I was eavesdropping on their conversation. They were finally potentially seeing me in a positive light. I don't want to do anything that might make me less likable. I'm gonna sneak on out of here before anyone finds out.
Maybe I was just seeing things.
Ugh. Whatever the case, I told you that I'm not going to answer your questions.
Why, though?
There's not a chance that I would tell anyone. Ikagi-kun is mine, and he's not for the taking. The first time that I met Ikagi-kun was shortly after I had started coming to university.
You're really cute, aren't ya? Would you want to go grab a bite to eat after this if you're free?
I can't do that. I was a very fancy lady in college. From kindergarten to high school, I had gone to fancy schools where only the richest and finest women go. I didn't want to not have any exposure to men, so for college, I went to a regular college. That's where I was surrounded by many, many men. I know it's kind of weird to say about myself, but I really did look good. And I was kind of stuck surrounded by a bunch of men when Isa helped me out.
Can you not see that she's clearly not into this? You know that you should really only try to pick up girls who are clearly looking to be picked up. You're not ever gonna succeed at this rate. Even if you were going to invite a girl out like that, you really shouldn't be going after a girl like this. I know because I've failed all 100 of my attempts, so I can give you some advice and pointers if you want.
You've literally failed every time?
I was working so hard and trying to find a girlfriend, but...
Oh, cheer up, bro. You wanna go grab a bite to eat or something?
Somehow, they had started to get along. Isa was apparently very good at getting along with people. Afterwards, I figured that I would find myself in more annoying situations if I stayed looking like this. So I decided to start dressing up like a man. There were many more girls talking to me, but I felt that it was still a lot better than being surrounded by hungry men. Then, I ran into Isa again in a certain lecture hall. Isa didn't seem to notice that I was the same girl that he had saved from before. He didn't make that connection in his head. Honestly, I wasn't sure if I should tell him who I was or not. He really helped me out, and I felt like hiding things from him was not the right thing to do. However,
dude, Akira, look at all the dishes on the menu for the school cafeteria. There's so many. I wonder how much time it's gonna take to get through all those dishes.
I couldn't tell him who I really was. I knew that if I did reveal to him who I was behind this disguise, he would change. So I couldn't bring myself to be honest. We had only just met, but I had so much fun being around him. I didn't want this friendship to disappear. The thought was just too terrifying. And now, we're both in our sophomore year of college together. Before I knew it, I had fallen for him. He's seriously one of the most decent, kind people that I know.
Dude, you totally just cut in line, didn't ya? You realize that there are a lot of people waiting in line, right? You need to go to the back of the line.
Isa is the kind of person that doesn't let anything bother him at all.
Do you feel sick? All right, I'll take you to the on-campus clinic real quick.
If someone is in need of some kind of help, He doesn't think twice. He reaches out and helps.
Here, you can have this.
Why?
Because you seem like you were down today. This is pretty much all I can do for you, so it's not like I can do much, but I hope that you at least feel a little bit better.
He's a considerate guy. Kinda naive. He's kind to literally everyone. He's kind of out of it and a little goofy sometimes. Well, often.
Oh man, that woman is so freaking gorgeous.
He's kind of a sleazeball sometimes too, but I fell for that man. I mean, there's no point in my hurrying. It's not like if I tell him who I am now, we're going to suddenly start dating or anything. I've got to take my time and don't rush things. It's not that I'm some kind of chicken or anything, so don't make that mistake. Whatever the case, it seems like Issa isn't very popular either. Things will be fine. It's fine. Or so I thought.
You get along well with Ikaga-kun, right? Could you maybe, like, introduce me to Ikaga-kun?
Huh? Issa is actually incredibly popular after all. Issa's been helping people out when I haven't been paying attention either, and there are a few girls in college that had fallen for him because of his kind actions. You could count on both hands how many there were that liked him, but I'm sure that there's a good chance that it will continue from now on, too. I can't believe that I had met this many rivals, but I mean, I guess for now, I'm the closest person to him, so I don't think I need to worry about anything. Or so I thought.
I want a girlfriend.
Oh, crap. This is really, really not good for me. Issa really wants a girlfriend. If Issa and a girl that Issa wants gets close to each other, they're going to start dating real quick. That's why I did all kinds of things to try to make sure that never happened. Specifically, I would pit each of the other girls against each other. The enemy of my enemy is not my ally, but everyone wants everyone to maintain the status quo for now. And so, I have been managing them all, maintaining balance, but on top of that, he's mine. You realize how well I get along with Issa, right? I tell them who I really am, and tell them that we're already very close to make them scared and run away. I mean, the truth is that we're really only close because we're good friends. I'm sure that from their point of view, we probably look like we're dating or something. But we haven't announced anything, so who knows what's actually going on. That's why I can't have anyone ask Issa about our relationship. And so, I make sure to do everything I can to make sure that the girls don't get closer to Issa at all. Who knew that the political tactics course I took in the fancy schools would come into handy here? I'm pretty scheming. Whatever the case, things are safe now.
I overheard something. Akira, you were being asked by a bunch of girls about me, right? I ran away because someone almost saw me, but still, I didn't realize that I was so popular. I'm so sorry that my popularity was causing you such a headache, but don't you worry anymore. I'm gonna handle all of them myself from now on. All right, it's time to make a girlfriend.
This is the worst.
After that...
I can't believe that I could talk to you, Ikaga-kun. I'm so happy.
Oh, come on. You don't need to worry about things too much. Relax. Don't be so uptight. I decided to talk to a girl that was interested in me.
Oh, this is not the kind of man that I thought he was.
What? So, yeah, now she's totally not into me at all.
I should not have worried about it at all.
Why? I pretended to act like a man that was super popular.
A super popular man?
I pretended to be you, Akira, like a kind of thing.
Can you explain how you see me?
I really screwed the pooch on that one. She was so stinking cute. I guess I have no way of ever finding a girlfriend.
I see. That kind of girl's your type, huh?
What's going on?
Nothing.
You sure?
Are you okay with dating literally anyone, Isa?
I don't care. Anyone is fine.
Wow. You just straight up said it out loud.
Do you realize that the only men who get to choose are the ones that are really popular? I don't really have any kind of right to choose anyone. I don't want to pick and choose. I'm not in a status where I can pick and choose. It's just easier for me to stick with liking the girl that fell for me.
But you are a popular guy.
That's true. You're totally right. I can pick and choose as I like.
We really should have a talk about your temptations.
I mean, I really do want a girl that I like too. You know, it's not like girls that like me are just gonna show up indefinitely. I need to take the chance on the girl that's with me now. I guess I'll give it another shot tomorrow. The next day. I'm sorry about yesterday. I kind of just got a little nervous.
It's totally fine. I didn't really let it bother me.
I decided to try talking to her again, and it actually went well this time. Apparently, I was making the mistake of trying to act cool with her.
This is not fair! Why is it just you two?
You can't just do that to us.
Let us in on this.
I can't believe that they actually liked me. I know they're all supposed to be into me, but I really can't believe it. If things go well, am I going to be dating one of them? I don't know how to put it, but I can't really imagine it. Is it because I've never really had a girlfriend in my life?
What is going on right now? What is this feeling? It's boiling from deep within me. Who the hell is that woman? Why is she touching him like that? Touching Issa's shoulder like that? What a freaking pervert. He's my Issa. Ah! She's so close to him. What do I do? At this rate, they're going to take him from me. I can't. I can't let them do that. Ugh. But I can't just sit here and do nothing. Do I just tell him who I really am? But I guess even if I tell him who I am, there's no guarantee that he's going to choose me. And if I tell him, I might lose my position with him as a friend. It might completely get screwed up. Issa's going to start dating one of those girls.
Akira, this is my girlfriend.
Nice to meet you. I'm girlfriend number one.
And introduce me to her like that? Then I'm going to completely break down. If things go even worse.
This is my second girlfriend.
I'm girlfriend number two.
There might be a girlfriend number two.
Girlfriend three right here.
Oh my god, a girlfriend number three?
Fourth?
Okay, I get it.
You want to be my fifth?
You can make me your fifth? No. That's not how it's going to go. Why did I feel like that was okay? Am I some kind of idiot or something? My imagination is expanding in the wrong direction. However, it's very possible that this can be a reality. We're not talking about girlfriends two and three or anything, but the possibility that Issa's going to have a girlfriend. There's no way he can have a harem, right? Whatever the case, I know that I won't be able to be girlfriend number anything just by watching. If I want to be his girlfriend number one, then I've got to do it. I might mess up our current relationship, but I don't want to let anyone else have Issa, even if it means risking that. I'm not going to let you have him. Because I liked Issa long before any of you did. It's the perfect BSS situation.
I was suddenly called up by Akira to a place where there were no people around. But Akira isn't here yet. What is he doing?
Sorry to keep you waiting.
There you are. Wait, who are you?
It's me.
Huh? Akira?
I'm sorry, I've been tricking you this whole time. I'm actually a girl.
I think I've, like, squeezed your ass a few times, right?
Yeah.
Huh. I immediately got on the ground because I didn't know what else to do. I thought that you were my best friend, and I was all preaching about how we were so close, but I thought that you were a man the whole time.
No, get off the ground, please.
I finally realized after she told me. Akira is clearly a very good-looking woman, no matter how you look at her. Yeah, she can kind of give off neutral sexuality vibes, and if you are told she's a good-looking man, then yeah, she can be. But this is something that I really should have noticed a long time ago. Why didn't I realize? I'm the worst best friend ever.
You really don't need to corner yourself like that. I was intentionally keeping it hidden from you, too. You really don't need to care so much about it.
Okay, I won't then.
That was really fast.
Well, you literally just told me that I don't need to care so much about it, so...
Yeah, but when you just completely switch gears that fast, it kind of upsets me a little bit.
But why didn't you just tell me sooner? Why did you hide it from me the whole time?
You know how I'm a good-looking woman.
I mean, yeah, you are a good-looking woman, so I can't say anything, but it's kind of annoying to hear.
A lot of boys wouldn't leave me alone, you know? So I dressed up as a man to avoid anyone messing with me.
I see.
You realize that we actually met before I started dressing up as a man, though, right?
Huh? Did we?
You don't remember?
Nope, I don't remember at all.
That's kind of annoying.
Sorry, when did we meet?
When the men were messing with me and you helped me get out of the sticky situation. It was right after I started college, remember?
Not at all.
Why?
Because there were a lot of girls that were being messed with when college started.
Seriously? How many times did you save or rescue a damsel in distress?
Well, there was a lady that almost got run over by a car.
I guess if something that shocking happened to me, I would forget something like just saving a girl from getting flirted with too.
Oh, and I helped an old lady when she was carrying something really heavy.
An old lady is also part of this damsel in distress plot. You really don't care at all who you choose in this situation, huh? Whatever the case, you really saved me. And then we met after I started dressing up as a man again.
Oh yeah, I remember you were really friendly with me from the moment we started hanging out. That's probably why, huh?
Asa, I am worried that my relationship with you might get completely screwed up, so I couldn't really tell you who I really was. If I told you that I was actually a girl, I felt like you might change your behavior.
Akira?
But recently, you've been hanging around other girls and laughing and giggling like a little girl, so I felt like I couldn't just stay like this.
Giggling like a little girl?
Yeah, you even had the, oh, come here you, I'm gonna catch you situation by the beach, too.
I definitely did no such thing.
Oh, sorry. That was just something I was fantasizing about. Sorry about that.
Yeah, let's definitely make a clear distinction between fantasy and reality.
Whatever the case, I didn't want that to happen. I didn't want you to be taken by some other girl.
So are you saying... Are you saying that you like me?
Yes, I like you, Issa. That's why I thought about telling you who I was. I didn't want anyone else to take you from me, even if that meant that I had to put my current relationship with you at risk. I want to make sure you were mine.
No, I'm me. I'm not going to be anyone's thing.
You can't just logic me like that.
I see. You liked me.
So what do you say? Do you think you can go out with me?
I mean, this is all so sudden, you know? The fact that you were a beautiful woman in disguise is already throwing me off. On top of that, you're telling me you like me. Honestly, I can't really process everything.
You can just answer me now before you're able to process everything. So just give me an answer.
I appreciate your honesty.
I've got a cute face.
You really don't care how you get my attention, huh?
Also, I've got a super strong family back at home.
You should care a little bit more about how you get my attention.
I've even got maids in my house.
Maids, you say? Are they gonna do the little cute dance for me?
Well, that got your attention.
I want omelets from a maid song, please.
I think you're mistaking it for some kind of weird service.
But I mean, it's probably weird for me to date you for that, right?
Ugh.
Just speaking seriously for a second, it's not like I'm okay with anyone. I want to date someone after really figuring out the kind of person they are, you know?
Really?
I told you before, I want to like the person that likes me. If I go out with the person without putting much thought into it and half-assing it, I'm just gonna make the two of us do something we regret. So, I want to date the kind of woman that's gonna make me feel like I could date this person.
So I'm not good enough?
No, that's not what I said. But I really liked you as my best friend. I can't just suddenly think of you as my girlfriend. It's impossible. But I definitely feel like I want to be with you more than with someone that I don't know, I think.
Huh?
I know you well, Akira, and I think the fact that you mustered up the courage to tell me the truth makes me feel good. I want to make sure I face that kind of honesty head on. I can't give an answer right now, but I'll definitely give you an answer, okay? Is that okay, Akira?
Issa, hold it right there.
Huh?
You can't just do that to us like that.
Wait, you were listening to that?
We like Akagi-kun too, you know?
You have to think about us, too.
I'm not going to let you have Akagi-kun.
Hey!
Oh, me too!
No! Issa is mine!
This is a really tough situation to be in. What do I do?
Maid, cute dance.
Mom, is there something you wanted from me?
Can you do the cute dance?
Huh?
The cute dance.
Ma'am, this isn't some weird cafe or something, so,
cute dance.
Love who?
I don't feel the cuteness.
You realize that real maids don't need to be all cute like that, right? I did not become a maid to do something like this.
Sorry,